ever find, the more wretched hive of scum and villainy. We must be cautious.
Welcome, welcome back to the Cantina, my ladies and gents. This is Stephanie, your friendly neighborhood bar manager, barkeep, wookie wrangler, chaos coordinator, scoundrel wrangler. You name it. You know the rules. Tip the Wookiees 20%. No droids, no bounty hunters, no Raylos. No Disney canon fans. Canon, they don't even have a canon, they even admitted it. No Disney fans, Star Wars fans of any kind. Oh boy, do we've got some interesting news today. Seems like, and I'm going to put a link to the StarWars.com story so you can all read it, that they're delaying the first two novels, Project Luminous novels, The High Republic, till next January. And the excuse is COVID-19. Anybody buy that? Anybody? You mean you can't sell novels through Amazon? BarnesandNoble.com, they're still a thing. The website, the Star Wars website itself. You mean you just can't do that? I've got a bunch of novels coming from Amazon. They're supposed to be here today. So I'm really not buying this excuse. Now, maybe it is an excuse, okay? With the country opening up, pretty much, with Democrat governors like that plastic-haired weirdo in California slowly but surely backing off their draconian measures. The only one still really digging her six-inch heels into the ground about the lockdown is that see you next Tuesday in New York, Gretchen Whitmer, or Michigan. Well, Andrew Cuomo's a see you next Tuesday too, so whatever. I'm not here to talk about COVID-19 and these assholes. I find this fascinating. I really, really do. I find it very fascinating. We know the financial straits Disney's in. We know that there's turmoil going on at Lucasfilm. Now, what could it be the other reasons? Maybe that people were laughing hysterically at the excerpts that we saw come out of the first novel written about Avar Chris, who's the bestest Jedi that ever lived. She's kind and she's courteous and she's warm and she's the light of the Jedi. Like him? Or Daddy? All right. And this novel written by Charles Soule, Justina Ireland's novel has been pushed back. Claudia Pegg Gray's novel's been pushed back too, and the comics have been pushed back to like next February. My speculation is, and this is just me, with all the turmoil going on at Lucasfilm, with Kennedy manhandling a lot of stuff going on, with her being kept away from the TV part, the Disney streaming, having a meltdown according to Doomcock, and I believe this because it is backed up by stuff I've heard about what's been going on, Mandalorian season 3 is already being worked on, the scripts are being worked on by Filoni, Favreau, and George Lucas, and she was not involved, and, you know, she, all right, I'll rehab the story. She calls Iger and says, we need to talk about the Mandalorian season 3, and Iger's like, well, they're already working on it with George, they meaning Favreau and Filoni. Kennedy lost her shit. Now, there's a subscriber here, I'm not going to say who, that actually got to see her up close and personal. Let's put it this way. Kathleen Kennedy makes Miranda Priestly look like St. Teresa of Lisieux. That's how big of a bitch she is. I mean, this guy was like, I got nothing to do with you, and left his boss hanging. And he's like, I'm out. Like to see her try that with a woman, with an alpha female, because women that act like that are not alphas, okay? She's definitely not an alpha. you know, if you wave the flag of victimhood and you don't just get on with your life, you're a beta, you're a whiner, you're a victim, you're not an alpha of any kind, shape, or thing. But anyway, so she screamed and ranted and raved and said she'd burn the place down if she didn't get her way. La-dee-da, fucking da. Well, 2 weeks later, Variety jumps out with the Leslie Headland is going to develop a show for Disney Plus, and it's female-centric, and it's all about ninja stuff and martial arts, and of course, there's a meltdown. The reason why is because, Leslie Headland is, again, one of those phony fucking Hollywood wannabes who kisses anybody's ass to get where she wants to go. I mean, hey, you know what? You can go find her tweets. They're out there. I've seen them. Praising her former boss, Harvey Weinstein. The videos are out there saying you always, the articles are out there. You always go home to daddy, Harvey being daddy. All right. But there she is, running around, saying she's got a show to develop with Lucasfilm for Disney Plus. Martial arts, female-centric, sounds like a piece of shit show. You know, just the idea. I'd be like, if I was Iger, I'd be like, there's the door. You can use it. What the fuck are you even talking about? I mean, so, anyway, this woman, somebody put it out there, either Kennedy herself or Headland jumped the ball. And then, of all places, Walt Disney Magic, Walt Disney World Magic, WDW.com, one of their main contributors said, the Bobs are freaking out. They're pissed off. That weekend, and it was like massive like meetings going on. Turns out Kennedy did not consult either Bob. They would have said no. Did not even consult Disney Legal, which is a big fucking no-no. First off, you gotta tell your boss what you're doing. Second of all, there are implications to hiring a former assistant to Harvey Weinstein because she has baggage with Weinstein, okay? And turns out that Bob Iger and Michael Eisner are both being sued for something that happened, God, this is years ago. Paz de la Huerta, actress, had a bad experience with Harvey and is suing them for something along with it. Eisner and Iger, to me, it looks like she's actually just suing Disney itself. One is chairman of the board right now and kind of CEO, kind of partially in the background. He's kind of like Darth Sidious, where Chapek is Vader. And you've got Michael Eisner, who's a former CEO. Do you understand where I'm going? She's suing both of them for something that happened years ago. To me, it looks like on paper, she's suing Disney, not really the Bobs. They've been named, but you know, has more to do with the company. Anyway, this sets a bad precedent again, because there's legal implications with hiring Mrs. Potato Head, Pinched Face, Headland, okay? So when it got announced officially, because Disney doesn't just leak shit out to the press, the Taika Waititi feature film being touted, then buried way underneath, maybe a paragraph, maybe even like three sentences long, Leslie Headland's TV show is announced. Look to you like Disney's like behind it. You think it's going to be made? No, it's not going to be made. And the reason simply is this. No money. They can say there's no money right now for it. It's just going to sit on the shelf. But now we got this thing with Project Luminous being pushed back. Why? I have a theory. Take it with a grain of salt, but just marinate on it. It's a theory. It's not a fact. It's based on things I've seen. George Lucas being attacked and, you know, snidely commented on in different articles. I've talked about that. The prequels being sniped at by Scott Mendelson at Forbes, saying they only made just a little more money than the sequel trilogy. Well, they were made for less money than any of the sequel trilogy movies, and they made more money if you look at the percentages. So, Scott Mendelson, fuck off. Okay. We got all that going on. We get a headline thing, which looks like another bit of retaliation. Kennedy, to me, it looks like she's playing all this out in public, under whatever. Then this gets pushed back. What if I was to say, what if? Just, what if? Publishing has been also taken away from her, or they're looking at it and telling the authors, because the reception for this amongst the fans was so bad. I mean, there are 5 SJW females and you know, the beta males that, you know, virtue signals to get laid that want to see this. But other than that, I don't want to read it. I mean, the paragraph of our Chris that we read from the description, and this is an adult novel. This is something written for somebody my age. Okay. It reads like for 8-year-olds. Do you understand where I'm going now with this? It was horrible. And the art is horrible. It's all just horrible. So what's going on? Well, they're pushing it back. Why? Probably to do some major rewriting and reimagining. They've got, all right, probably 10 months. Right, it's almost June to July, July to August, August to September, September to November, November to January or December. 6 months. A little over 6 months. 7 months, we'll give them. That's not a lot of time, but the fact that they're pushing it back tells me that it has more to do with rewrites and maybe what's going on with publishing right now in general and what's going on with Lucasfilm in particular. You know, let's put it this way. Comic books aren't being sold. If you follow Ethan Van Sciver, he's the only, him and the Independent Comics War Campaign, they're the only ones that are selling comics right now. Mainstream DC comics, Marvel, are not being sold anymore. In fact, pencils down. That's basically, we're not making these anymore. That's the message that you get. And I am like, so part of it might be economics. Fan reaction was like, what the fuck is this? You know, part of it is probably what's been going on behind closed doors at Lucasfilm. Now, here's something to watch. Frank Marshall announced a couple of things. The Indiana Jones project is still going on with Harrison Ford. Steven Spielberg's still part of it. And he also mentioned another Bourne movie, Jason Bourne. I mean, perfectly honest, I can't stand Matt Damon. I look at him and he just makes me go. He's not my type. B, you know, 40, 50 years ago, if he'd come to Hollywood, they'd laughed him right off the stage. It'd been like, you get a TV show, a sitcom, and that's it. Because you're not a feature film actor. Feature film actors are, leading men are handsome, just drop dead. They're not cutie pies. They're handsome. They're beautiful. There's a big difference between pretty and beautiful for a man, right? A woman can be pretty and beautiful. A man can either be one or the other. It can't be both. Because then that goes into the, you question their sexuality. And Matt Damon is about as big a turn on as mashed potatoes without butter. It's just like, okay, whatever. So anyway, I want to talk a little bit about this. The fact that those two movies are still was announced by Frank Marshall himself, and Indy 5 is still on. Maybe, just maybe, Kennedy will slip out of her role at Lucasfilm to help her husband. It's where she belongs anyway. You know, don't you think? Don't you think it's time? The winds of change, please. Anyway, this is Steph signing out. Kind of giggling right now. I'll see you on the galaxy.